discovered what the boundary layer is and how it forms. We have seen that the boundary layer is generated by viscous effects. It is first laminar and then it transitions to turbulent, while increasing in thickness as it grows along the body. We studied different methods to analyze a laminar boundary layer. We introduced the boundary layer theory and the equations that govern boundary layers. We performed an integral analysis of the boundary layer and compared it to the exact solution that Blasius derived for a flat plate. Then we analyzed methods to extend the solution to non-uniform inflows and boundary layers subject to pressure gradients, as well as solutions for different shapes than a simple flat plate, such as wedges or expansion corners. We also extended the equations to the full three-dimensional form, introducing the concept of secondary flows. We concluded with the description of the matching principle, combining the solution of two different regions of the boundary layer to obtain a description for the entire velocity profile. The importance of analyzing the boundary layer is to move from a simple inviscid analysis to the analysis of viscous flows, in order to be able to calculate the friction acting on the body surface and calculate the drag that the body will be subjected to. In addition to that, the analysis of laminar boundary layers lays the foundation to the analysis of turbulent boundary layers and flow separation.